afternoon, graduates, families, and distinguished guests, as well as staff and students. It's my pleasure to be here to help honor the St. André Bessette Catholic School graduating class of 2021. I'm incredibly proud to stand before you to recognize the accomplishments of these students, of our students, as I've watched as I've watched you mature over the past few years. It's given me confidence that you will continue to journey on to becoming successful adults. This makes me proud. When I look back at these last 4 years, I am blessed to have known each of you. I am confident that you will move on in your life after high school with the potential to help make the world a better place. I also know and acknowledge that this hasn't been the grad that most of you have hoped for. Please know that it's not the grad I had hoped for either. As a staff, we have lived with you, grown with you, learned from you, watched you grow up, shared laughs, and generally come to know and appreciate you all over these past few years. And we do also enjoy sharing in a grand celebration at the end of it all with you, and we're feeling a loss of that as well. And please realize this pandemic has taken this away from us as well as you, and we're sorry for this. Nevertheless, we sincerely appreciated having you as our students, and please accept my heartfelt thanks for sharing a portion of your lives with us, and we wish you the very best in where life takes you. And my final wish is that you set out from here to help make the world a better place and be the best people you can be. I'm exceptionally proud of the people that you have become, and may God bless you as you walk the path through life, and know that we will continue to pray for you as you move on to the next phases of your lives. And lastly, don't forget, as I say every year, once a cardinal, always a cardinal. Go out there and make us proud. Congratulations, everybody. Thank you.
Welcome and congratulations. My name is Sean Haggerty, Superintendent of Elk Island Catholic Schools, and I am incredibly honored to be part of the graduation ceremonies of St. André Bessette Catholic School. I'd like to say a special thank you to all the entire staff and the graduation committee for all the hard work and preparation leading up to today. And congratulations to the 2020 graduates of St. André Bessette. Recognize and celebrate your accomplishments of the last 13 years and look forward to the future. The grads of St. André Bessette are ready for the world, and the world is certainly waiting for you. Every year, Elk Island Catholic Schools has a faith-based theme that guides us throughout the school year. And this year, our theme was Choose Joy. It came from 1 Peter chapter 3, 15, which is the reason for our hope. Center your life and your future decisions on what is right. Christ is the reason for our hope, and through all of life's experiences, purposefully and consciously choose joy. The opportunities waiting for you outside of the walls of St. André Bessette are endless. And as you encounter challenges or difficult decisions the next few years, know that you are prepared to face them. With the support of your faith, your family, and God's love, you are so ready to navigate through these situations. And let your faith in yourself and all that you can achieve be stronger than your fears. So once again, congratulations to the graduates of St. André Bessette Catholic School. God bless.
Sorry, I'm tall. Hello, I'm Ezra. For those of you watching who happen not to be in grade 12, or if you are in grade 12 and only just heard my name for the first time, hi, this is what the bottom of my face looks like. This year, I have the unique distinction of being this school's first salutatorian. You may ask, is that a real thing? And what does that mean?
I've been told the answer to the first question is yes, and as for the second, it means I bribed the wrong people. What it actually means is that I came in second, grades-wise, to my constant irritants, but I do get to talk first, and now you have to flip through two pages in the yearbook. So ask yourself, who really came out on top? But it is my honor to welcome you all to this virtual celebration. Even though you've all been here for a while. But that in itself is a great reminder that this is all different than we imagined. I know when I imagine myself in this position, I imagine myself staring out at a sea of faces, all silently pleading with their eyes for me to be brief and just let them leave. I know many of you imagine yourselves decked out and dolled up in the gym for what should be, and still is, an exciting day. But this year is different. I know, we've all heard it far too often for the past year. Things have changed. We're all in this together. Enhanced cleaning protocols seems to be a uniquely popular one. And we get it, right? First global pandemic in a century. Gotta keep our grandparents safe. Constantly thinking, that'll probably be fine if I catch it, but what if I spread it to my parents? Are they going to be okay? Are my older relatives going to be okay? What's with all the people wearing their masks under their nose? Don't they understand how breathing works? I was close contact. Is my nose running because of that, or is it just allergies? Why, in the year of our Lord, 2021, were people protesting public health measures? Forget all the schoolwork for a second. Fear and isolation were our biggest challenges this year. I'll admit, the last year and a bit have made me lose some of my faith in humanity. And what's the response to that? They told me, Ezra, you're going to be our first salutatorian. No one's going to know what that means, but just go out there, welcome everybody, use your personality and humor to warm up the crowd. I don't know what they were thinking. Coming from a guy who has, well, it could be worse, as a personal motto, I think I'm hardly in a position to look at you all and say, we should all just look on the bright side. But that doesn't mean that we should forget to highlight the little spots of light that we see. I think each and every one of us deserves a damn medal for at the very least showing up, pulling ourselves out of bed every morning, well, most mornings at least, and coming here to do the one thing that really matters, complain about our schoolwork. Oh, and then do the schoolwork, but only if there's time. But despite all the pain and suffering and the numbness we've come to feel when they announce the daily death toll and hospitalizations, we have seen scientific leaps and bounds being made before our very eyes. Technologies that are revolutionizing the fight against disease are currently being deployed on a massive scale. I know many of us have already benefited from our first shot, and so can see a spot of hope on the horizon. Despite our many struggles and moments of doubt, we've never truly lost our hope. That hope has carried us from our first days in kindergarten and what was then Pope John. Whether you were in the blue group, the red group, the green group, we were all still little snot-nosed kids, a little nervous about our first day, wondering whether our teacher would be nice, whether we'd like the other kids, whether the class would be fun enough. The blue group was still best. Fight me on it. I dare you. But we needn't have worried. Mrs. O'Meara was great. Mrs. Dulcide, I assume, was as well. I don't know. She never really taught me, so. But our sense of hope continued as we progressed through those early days at elementary. We got to experience all the things you're supposed to at that age. Assemblies, library days, Halloween parties, Christmas concerts, screaming our heads off on the Christmas tree at the playground. Though I think for many of us, our first experience of true tragedy was exactly 11 years ago today, the day that Connor died. And at that age, it's hard to understand when misfortune and death strike. And further tragedies have affected us since. But for me at least, being forced to see the unfairness and the uncaring reality of what life sometimes is has made me appreciate the time I've been given with you people that much more. Going up through the rest of elementary, being kind of freaked out by the wasp's nest in Mrs. Warren's grade 2 class, doing what were probably horrible plays for the first time that are only looked back on now fondly because of how cute we all were. Going into grade 3 and 4 where we were lied to about the importance of handwriting. Thank you, Mrs. Rockwell. I am now the scourge of all my teachers' written assignments. But we got to enjoy all of that. And I think it's important to remember how privileged we are to have gotten to experience any of this at all. Then we all went on to OLA. Man, am I glad we all chilled out by now. Whoever thought it was a good idea to take that many hyperactive kids on a camping trip in grade 6? But I digress, because they were formative years nonetheless. And I'll admit, I did cheat at grounders every time we played because I'm allergic to falling off playground equipment on my face. I know, I hope you can find it all in your hearts to forgive me. And I'll be honest, grades 7 and 8 really blur together for me, probably because not only did I have the same teacher, I had the same locker for some horrible reason. I may not remember much distinctly from those years, but I do remember grade 8 English. Not for the content, but for the people. Specifically the people who left that unclaimed sandwich behind the filing cabinet for a few weeks without being, shall we say, disturbed. But in the end, it was educational. We all learned how mold grows in an airtight environment. Let's just say during that time, we really made our teachers earn their paycheck. And then we moved on to the big one, high school. Last year at JP2, I'm just gonna come out and say it. I was way more scared of the grade 12s then than the grade 9s are of me now. Must be my calm demeanor and care for the children. There's also the strange phenomenon where grade 9s cluster together in the halls and manage to take up the entire hall. We did it, every year after us did it, generations from now they'll still do it. I don't know what it is at that age that makes you incapable of moving 2 feet either side, but it's some universal cosmic force apparently. Then, in grade 10, we got a new school. I don't know about you, but finally having a dedicated drama room that wasn't some side classroom with carpet that was around when the Berlin Wall fell made me weak in the knees. You should have seen Kevin Cross hype it up. I've been told the other facilities are nice too. And I know the whole washroom thing has been done to death. I'd just like to meet the architect who thought that putting urinals in 1/3 of the gender-neutral washrooms was a good idea. Now, I'm not entirely sure what I'm supposed to say about grade 11. The first half was fun. The global pandemic made me prefer doing modules. I've never experienced such low-level constant anxiety. And I can feel the eyes rolling like, oh crap, he's going back to the pandemic. We get it, it sucked, we were there. But this is what I get for poor speech organization. And yes, there were people I absolutely dreaded having to be locked in a room for 80 minutes with. But you know what? Since then, I've come around, and now, in my mind, I think they're at the very top of the bell curve. Furthermore, we shouldn't forget how we got here, and who got us here. Thank you to my parents for always asking my best, and more importantly, accepting what my best is. Thank you to my grandparents and aunts and uncles for providing such a wonderful foundation for me and my family through the good times and the struggles. Thank you, Father Chris and Father Daniel, for your continued work and patience, and we all wish you well in your new parishes. Thank you to all the teachers, aides, support staff, and admin who've helped us nurture our abilities for these last 13 years, for sacrificing your personal time so we can have sports, contests, and drama productions, for making sure that we didn't set fire to anything too important, and to let us do fun and kind of dumb stuff like throwing pumpkins from the second floor balcony, or all getting around Van de Graaff generator turned up all the way up at the same time. That was electrifying, to say the least. Because, ultimately, we may not remember exactly how to do stoichiometry, or what the appendix's purpose is, but we will remember the people who helped us along the way. Shakespeare once said that brevity is the soul of wit, and if the length of this speech is any indication, I sorely hope he was wrong. But thank you all for letting me pay some tribute to the last 13 years of my life. And I hope all 5 of you who didn't skip today feel I did an okay job. Now, I get to hand it off for the last speech, we promise, to your valedictorian, David McMaster. But before I go, remember, it's only the worst year of our lives so far.
Thank you.
hope you're all having a great day. I'd like to remind everyone that we're on Treaty 6 territory, meaning that we're on a number of this province's indigenous peoples' territory, and we share it with them. Rather, they share it with us. In addition, I'd like to share my parents, the teachers, and the friends who have helped me throughout my school journey. I'm going to be honest. I'm not a very good public speaker. I'm just a nerd who sits alone in a basement all day on a computer looking up things about the world. I think it's interesting. Most people don't. To start off, let me tell you a story of a young boy born with intense anxiety who managed to push through his fear and become the top of his class. Early on, this boy was petrified by failure and believed that, as naive as it may seem, that failure meant the end of the world. Then, with the help of one teacher in the third grade, Ms. Rockwell, I think she was thoroughly mistreated by many people, she helped me through my anxiety. I will be forever grateful for that. And I learned to uninvest myself from the world around me. With that boy was free. No outside expectation could push him, and he was happy. As the boy grew older, he began to wonder what would happen if he put a little more effort into his schoolwork. So out of curiosity, he did. Much to his surprise, even a little extra effort greatly improved his performance. This inspired him to see just how far he could go. It was not an easy ride. His anxiety returned, but unlike before, the only expectations he cared about were his own. Today, this boy stands before you as valedictorian. Why did I tell you this? Because I want to encourage the people who are trying their best in school, work, or sports, or anything that requires dedication, to keep pushing forward. There are times when society will make things difficult and the whole world may seem against you, but I mean this in the most sincere way, keep going. As when you achieve your goal, you will be far happier than if you gave in to outside pressure. I planned on speaking more about a few other topics, but there are a few subjects that kind of push their way through which matter a bit more. In particular, the recent reminder of the tragedy which has stricken our great nation's indigenous population cannot be ignored. As you may have heard, the bodies of over 215 indigenous children between the ages of 3 and 18 were found on the grounds of the Kamloops Residential School last month. This has not been an occurrence in Canada alone. Upwards of 6,000 children are known to have died while attending these schools, equivalent to one death in every 25 students, about one in every class in the school. For indigenous people, the death of these students have reverberated throughout their communities, both when it happened as well as now. I bring up these issues because, throughout recent history, such issues have often been silenced. I, for one, refuse to let such atrocities fall into obscurity, and I know that, as a graduating class, we have the power to prevent such an event from ever happening again. When listening to those who have been personally affected by these injustices, we are granted a better perspective into the truth of our shared history. By acknowledging these individuals and their experiences, we have the ability to make positive changes and improvements to our current flawed system and other systems that still oppress people. So let us come today and come together and bring about a far brighter future than what we have been left with, for we have all the potential for immense greatness. Thank you, and live long and prosper, guys.